Celtics with 67 points with 6:45 remaining. Tatum drives down and throws it down! Wow!
Here we go.
They want Tatum. Tatum is the guy.
Against Barrett. 3 seconds. The three. Got it. Jayson Tatum with 1.3 to go has given Boston the lead. Tatum a game winner. And the Celtics with the win over the Knicks in Boston after Morris tied it late in regulation.
Before we start today's video, I want you guys to comment down below if you could pick one young NBA player from today, who would it be to be your franchise piece? And hey, when you guys are down there, go ahead and drop a like on the video and subscribe if you're new to the channel. Obviously, a lot of you guys would say Luka Doncic or Zion Williamson, and honestly, you can't make a wrong choice with either one of those two. But if Jayson Tatum is not anybody's pick, I'm really not sure what you're thinking. Now, the past three seasons, Jayson Tatum has improved every single year. And this year, he was having an insane year, you know, before the NBA got put on pause. He was averaging 23 plus points a game, about 8 rebounds, shooting about 40% from three. He was really carrying a very good Boston Celtics team. Well, we'll talk a little bit more about Jayson Tatum in the video, guys. Today, we are on my 6'7" facilitating finishing slasher build, guys. This is honestly, I know I say this a lot, but this is probably my favorite build to play on. If you guys would like to see the build video for this, I know it's July, but this build is so good. I really think it deserves a full out tutorial on how to make it. Real quickly, we'll take a look at the stats. Look at this, 89 driving dunk, which 99.9, you'll have a 90 driving dunk, but you know, slashing takeover and all that. So it's actually really good at, you know, getting contact dunks. The 67 three ball, you guys will see in the video and you've seen it before, is more than you really need. The 83 ball handle, so after you make like one shot or like one assist, you'll be able to speed boost for the rest of the time. Good defensive stats, good lateral quickness, you know, pretty decent vertical and strength. But the biggest thing, guys, is the speed right here. The quick first step with it, guys, is absolutely insane. So we'll go ahead and take a look at the badges real quick. This is what I was using in the gameplay, just showing you guys real quickly everything that I'm using. Catch and shoot, clutch shooter, corner specialist, Deadeye, you know, hot zone hunter, range extender, green machine. Really the only big three that you really need, but with 23 shooting badges, guys, this build shoots lights out. And then I haven't maxed out my playmaking yet, but like I was saying, man, the 90 plus speed with quick first step at 6'7" is absolutely insane. And then we have a good amount of defensive badges as well. You guys seen a lot of the highlights defensively. This build really has no weaknesses. But like I said, guys, if you would like to see this build video, go ahead and drop a like on the video. I'll post it probably next week. If we can get 3,000 likes, I know it's aiming for a lot, but this build is honestly the most fun I've had on a guard build in a long time. But without further ado, legend Jayson Tatum, let's go ahead and get right into it. Now, as we sit here and wait 2 minutes because these guys decided to close up, I thought it would be a perfect time to start talking again about the NBA and how it's going to start to resume in about 3 more weeks, which I cannot wait for. I think this finals and playoffs run is going to be insane to watch. Now, on the West Coast, we all kind of understand that it's most likely going to be the Lakers or the Clippers that come out of there. We can, you know, it's kind of up in the air, whichever one. But in the East, a lot of people just kind of decided it was just going to be, you know, the Bucks, and there's pretty much no other race to that. And I'm here to tell you guys today, I really don't think that's that easy. Like I was saying in the beginning of the video, if you could pick one player under 22 years old to start your team, I'm starting to really kind of go towards Jayson Tatum. Now, hear me out, guys. Jayson Tatum's game is complete. Right now, it's only getting better. You could just get better with Jayson Tatum's game. There's not really much that he needs to work on. Averaging 23 points, about 8 rebounds, 3 assists. Maybe that's something that he can start working on. Maybe as he starts to handle the ball a little bit more, he'll probably get more assists and his usage will go up. But 23-8 is a third-year player. Plays insane defense, can shoot the basketball very efficiently already. Like I told you guys, listen to this. In the month of February where he won Player of the Month, he had 30 points a game, shooting 50% from the field and 40%+ from the three. I think it was 48 or something ridiculous like that from three, which is insane for a whole entire month. Now, like I said, Jayson Tatum's complete game. He could drive and dunk the basketball. He could finish around the rim very easily. We've seen him even dunk on LeBron James's rookie year. Remember that in the playoffs, he's dunking on LeBron James. And like I said, his shooting got a lot better. His confidence is definitely going up. He's averaging about 10 more points a game and shooting more efficiently this year. And honestly, I think Jayson Tatum is due for a crazy year. Now, like I said, I was talking about in the beginning of the video, when we're talking about these young players, if you think about it, Luka Doncic is obviously a lot of people will say, and honestly, you can't go wrong with Luka either. He has a pretty complete game. Everybody will just look at the stats and, you know, see him pretty much averaging a triple-double. But you got to think his usage is very high as well. But his shooting's not really up there yet. He's shooting about like 30%, which isn't the best. And, you know, like I said, his defense is not that great and his efficiency is not amazing. But this is why I'm talking about Jayson Tatum. He kind of has that complete game. His defense is amazing. Like I said, he can shoot very efficiently. So when people say Jayson Tatum, I think they're right. Now, granted, his February run where he just went off, Kemba Walker wasn't playing. But even with Kemba Walker coming back, the Celtics team was even better. Now, when you think about Jayson Tatum, like I said, he's 6'8" with a 7-foot wingspan. He's basically a guard in a 6'8" body with a 7-foot wingspan. And plays great defense, can finish around the rim very well. And I'm not just talking about layups and tough finishes. This guy is throwing down posterizing dunks, hitting step back threes, game winners. And that's what your team needs if you want to win a championship. Now, the thing that people always talk about is having that one go-to guy in the playoffs. Like, you have to have somebody that can just go out there and get you a bucket. Is Luka Doncic that guy? He might be, but he might also be that more of the LeBron type of role, which isn't necessarily bad. It's going to be that guy. If you see the right play, you'll make it happen. But I really just think being that guy that can score the basketball at will is going to put your team in an advantage. And that's what Jayson Tatum is. You give him the ball, he can score in any way, take you off the dribble, pull up in your face, shoot over you. Like I said, he's 7-foot wingspan, drive and dunk and posterize you. Like, this dude is probably the real deal. And I think out of next 5 years, I think Jayson Tatum is the best player in the league. Now, let's talk a little bit about this build. As you guys can see, we're going up against two lockdown defenders. You already know our body. It's crazy that you won the ISO lockdowns this year. It's so weird how that's the case. Like, obviously, ISO should be the toughest thing to do against a lockdown, but it's just so much easier than using screen. So right here, we're just going to have him go to the corner. We're sitting here ISOing, and look, we're getting contact dunks on a lockdown defender. This build gets tons of contact dunks. It can shoot the basketball very well. You guys should know by now the meta this year. You only have to have like a mid-60s three-pointer, and if you have hot spots and hot zone hunter, you can shoot like a sharpshooter. But you can see we're just ISOing up just a little bit, messing up a tiny bit, but we're just reading how this guy's actually, you know, defending me. He is giving me the three every single time. But with this build, guys, the quick first step on Hall of Fame, it's game changing. You can just blow by defenders. I have like a 94 speed. So if I get the quick first step and I get by somebody, it's just so quick. You can see contact dunks if they sit in the paint. If they guard up on you, it's a blow by. If they sit back on you, it's a three pointer. It's just too easy. So if you guys want to see this build, you guys have to let me know down below in the comment section. I will drop it for you guys. Like I said, I know it's July and the game is almost over and all that, but as we're doing this, I think I heard there's no more events left. So this is like, if you're still trying to hit legend, which I don't know, maybe some of you guys are, but if you're still trying to hit legend, this is the perfect build. It can catch lobs and get good rep. It can also throw lobs and get good rep, and it's actually a really fun build and it's good. You can see nice little smart IQ play right there. I'm telling you guys, I don't miss three-pointers on this build. I hardly do. Now, these guys ended up pulling back again. And like I said in my last video, if you guys seen it, go check it out. The link to that will be up in the card somewhere. It might have already been there. But my Kobe Bryant build, I pretty much showed you guys how we were just going up against lockdown after lockdown after lockdown. Two lockdown lineups. And basically, that's all we played here as well. Now, this gameplay is a little bit more interesting. I did turn the ball over. I think I threw a scary to the corner, and he was actually reading it. And yeah, as you guys can see, pretty much this was the result of that. We're going up against two slashers that would just go down and hold your right analog stick pretty much the whole entire time. We did get a few stops, but like I said, it's pretty tough to actually score on lockdowns very like consistently. I'm not gonna lie to you, it's not the easiest thing to do, especially if they're pretty good, because these lockdowns with Hall of Fame clamps, they could pretty much prevent your drive. And if you don't get the best angle, it's pretty much a GG. But you see right here, very nice move. That's why I love using the Allen Iverson size up. But we end up missing it. That's like one of my few misses. And they end up getting takeover. And watch this right here, man. This is the most annoying thing ever. Like, I don't know how that goes in. These lockdowns can play Hall of Fame defense and, you know, have high 90s driving dunk, high 90s defensive stats. And if you upgrade these pure lockdowns correctly, you could actually shoot and dribble with them. Like, you could have pro dribble moves and you could still shoot with them, which is absolutely insane. But you can see we got to cook up just a little bit, do a little bit of the cheesy stuff. You know, this build, like I said, it's very well rounded, just like Jayson Tatum. It does pretty much everything. But you guys, sometimes you got to know, you got to do the cheesy things to get by. You can see just straight ISO right here. AI size up, kind of read what he's doing, and he's playing way too high, and you just blow by him. If they play high on you, you can blow by them very easily with this build. If they sag off, like I said, you can shoot the basketball like we're about to do right here. Actually, you know, we got to keep up on the toes. You're keeping me on my toes too. I thought I was going to shoot that, but we end up stepping it back and driving in for the easy two. Now we're down by two, you know, but we got to go up right here. A couple snatchbacks, size him up, seeing what he's doing, leaving me wide open. Look how deep that is, guys. That's 67 three ball. And it doesn't matter. You guys can see clutch shooter pop up at the top. I think that's a pretty underrated badge. If you guys have like more badge slots than you really need, I would very much so suggest using that. Very smart to go right up on my analog stick right there to get the easy dunk. But this will be the game. You can see we came back. I think it was like 16-4 or 16-6 or something like that against two lockdowns. Like I said, guys, if you want to see this build soon, you guys got to let me know down below in the comment section. I will drop this video for you guys. You can see nice little move to the moving shot to end it. But guys, hopefully you did enjoy the video, all 21 on two locks. It's been your boy Dignify, and I'm out. Peace.